Today I'm pleased to be talking to Mick Cripps of the Brutalist XLA Guns. Mick, say hi to everybody.
Hello everybody.
Mick, who are the Brutalists?
The Brutalists are me and Nigel Mogg, Kent Holmes, Luke Bosendorfer, and Charlie Nice. And we operate between England and Los Angeles.
How did you come to start a band with Nigel Mogg, the ex-choir boy?
Well, me and Nigel have known each other since in the 1980s in London, and from the choir boys. We're all good friends, and Kent and Charlie and Luke were people in various bands that I've been playing with over the last few years, and it kind of just came together. That's how those things happen.
How would you describe the style of the music of the Brutalists?
Rock and roll, dance music. You can dance to.
You know, I think it's kind of a combination of rock and ska, which is like quite unusual. Is that the point? I thought that's kind of the point, isn't it?
Well, you dance to ska, right?
Yeah.
The ska, a little bit of reggae, a little bit of old 50s rock.
Yeah.
Things that everybody likes.
What are the band's influences, would you say, then?
Everything. So we can sit here for the next 3 hours and listen to all. But, a lot of vintage music.
Right, yeah. Right. Okay. Now, the band has a new album out. Tell us about that.
Yeah, the title, it just came out a couple weeks ago on Cleopatra Records. It's called We Are Not Here to Help.
And not here to help.
Yeah, we're not here to help. She knows. It's our second album. We put the first one out called The Brutalists a year ago. And we did a little tour of England, and we're back a year later with a new album, and here we are.
Now, how do you think the second album compares to the debut?
It's similar in themes and stylistically. It's similar, but you have longer time to write the songs and put it together, so it's maybe a little bit more slick, had a little more time to produce it a little bit better. So, you improve. If you don't, you should give up, right?
Okay, yes, absolutely. Although you guys have all been doing it quite a long time now, so you've got a lot of experience.
You should know.
It's a bit land and town for an international band. Give us the background to that.
That comes from Nigel, because he's got he's the coffee. So, that's where that comes from.
But you guys are international. You're Australian and then now American?
Luke's from Bedford.
Oh, right. Yeah. Okay. And there's another American in the band as well?
Yeah, and Charlie's from Rhode Island.
Right. Now, you do
and Kent's from Michigan.
Right, okay. Now, you guys are doing some gigs in the UK. I was at the Dublin Castle in London the other night. The reaction was amazing. You must be really pleased about that.
Yeah. We play a lot of small clubs in downtown Los Angeles. We don't do the Hollywood thing, so we like the vibe in downtown.
Okay.
So,
And
down dirty.
What's next for the Brutalists?
Finishing this tour, we got a few more shows, and then we got shows lined up in LA and the Bay Area till through the end of the year.
Okay.
Doing a video for the next single, Price on Your Head. So we got to get that done. Let's keep laughing.
Okay, now you started out in a band called Faster Pussycat, but it's not Timely's Faster Pussycat.
No.
It's a different band. Explain that a little bit.
That was a band that was here, and it was just a Russ Meyer movie,
Yeah. But there's no connection between the two bands, it's just a coincidence.
No.
Except Tracy Guns was in your version of
Pussycat. Me and Tammy were just friends, and we would talk about it. I think I suggested that would be a good title because we weren't using it or anything. It's just a title.
Okay.
So you get good with it.
So there is a connection. Now, you were part of the classic lineup of LA Guns. Do you have good memories about that?
Oh yeah, that was an unbelievable experience. We saw the world. Those guys are still out there. They're still doing good. Still talk to them all. So we did our thing and they kept going. I think the last thing I did was in 2000.
Yeah.
Did a couple reunion records and things. So they're still out there doing it.
Now, the first album, it's a real classic, so you must be really proud of that album. I mean, it's got real legs, you know?
Yeah. I think the second one was the one that was really big.
Okay. I saw LA Guns in 1987 in the States, but I was really wasted, so all I remember is I really enjoyed it. But I was 18, so there you go. What did you do musically between LA Guns and the Brutalists then? Just tell us a little about what you did in the years between.
Well, I played the choir boys for like 10 seconds, and then I did a band called Burning Retina. Then I did a band called Mind Phaser, which was kind of a psychedelic band that we were putting down. And then I did play for a long time.
Started
playing.
So did Nigel encourage you to get back into
it? No. We were just jamming in the studio, and one day Guy said, "Why don't you try to be the frontman?" And we said, "You know, do a little Ian Drury kind of thing." And he pulled it off, so it kind of went from that.
Okay.
He just didn't want to lug his bass around anymore.
He's very wise, he's smart. Are you working on any other projects that you'd like to tell us about?
Well, we got enough to do right now.
Okay. All right, Mick, thank you very much for making some time to talk to us. Best of luck with the new album.
Thank you.